Okay. Yeah, Sachin. Can you tell me something about you first?
Yeah, means my name is Sachin Singh, and I am a BSc second year student of BSc General, and currently I am preparing for government and as well as competitive exams.
Okay,
and my hobbies are, yeah, government and competitive exam, any competitive exam means as along with studies.
Okay, and that's very good.
Yeah, and my hobbies are playing chess, reading novels, and doing daily exercises.
Oh, very good. You are a very health freak type.
Yeah, that means it's very.
In this corona time, we also need to be, our immunity should be very good to prevent us from coronavirus. So, do you take any coaching or something for your competitive exams?
No. Till yet, I didn't prefer any coaching exam as I am thinking means I can do with myself, and later on means taking help from the YouTube.
Okay.
And later, I will thought when I will be in third year, so surely I will go for any coaching if I don't feel that I will not able to clear or have any confidence issue regarding this.
No. You have very good confidence, and you should, of course, you will clear all your exams. Coaching center just means it's provide guidance, na? Of course, everyone needs guidance.
Yeah, and also means for the guidance and as well as for the consistency practice means when they go to coaching, so they are well focused regarding their exam and preference. And I think if I am able to focus and give time towards my preparation, so it will be very helpful for me. Means I don't need any coaching if I am so much focused for my exams.
Okay. I wish all the best to you for your future exams.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Yeah.
Whenever it happens, okay. As you already say, like you also take help with YouTube. So today's topic is also related with this.
Yeah, exactly. Right. Huh.
Coincidentally, today's topic is impact of social media on youth and teens. Okay. So according to you, what's your opinion about social media first?
So actually, first of all, if I start, so social media platform is a behavioral disorder in which young teens and young adults are so much attentive to social media platform that they are not able to reduce their online platform consumption, means their net consumption. They are not able to reduce their time consumption in all these platforms.
How they spend their time. Instead of doing physical activities, nowadays kids spend their time on social media.
Yeah, most of the time they spend on the online platforms. They are switching from one platform to another. And I think all these things leads to their behavioral disorders like mood swing and no patience in them. They are procrastinating all the things. And also, they don't want to do any hard work. Means they need just anything very easily. Don't want to do any efforts to get it.
Okay. So, according to you, social media is good or bad? Because everything has its own advantages and disadvantages, as we know.
Right. Yeah, I know. Means like everything has, as you said, that all have the advantages and disadvantages. But I think for the young adults and teens, it's mostly, or say that maximally, it's a disadvantage because they don't have any idea means how to utilize their time in social media platform. And these platforms are built in such a way that it make addictive to them in all these stuffs. And they spend a lot of time in this platform and they don't have any idea means where they have spent their time. They can't even analyze themselves, how they spend their day. Like, they don't have any idea how much time they spend on YouTube.
So, according to you, so my question, like whatever you said, I have one question. Yeah. So, according to you, we should limit the time for uses of social media.
Yeah, for teens, young adults, if they are able to manage, like they means like we can't at this age, we can't able to manage our time also. So, for them, it's also very
difficult. It's not about only for the teens. It's for the youth also. Nowadays, we see.
Yeah, right.
Parents also busy in their phones only. They don't focus on the children as much, you know, as they want. They want to focus.
Yeah.
But just because of the social media, they are not able to focus.
Yeah, so, and also they have a lot of options available also on social media platforms. So they find interest in different platforms.
Okay. So in this, we have a one solution also, na? We can set a age also to use social media.
Yeah.
As we have license to drive a car, we have a fixed age.
Right, right. Exactly.
After that age only, we can get our license and we can drive a car. So in that way also, for the social media uses, we also fix the age also, at least 12 or 13 something, so that after 12 or 13, children get the opportunity to use the social media. So is it right according to you or not?
Yeah, actually means I totally agree with you. Means there must be a license of the for the social media platform is after 12 age, because before the age of 12, it's very necessary for them to develop their physical and mental development, as it will help them to shape their life and future upcoming, because the whatever they will learn in this 10 to 12 years, so it will help them to tackle the problems in their upcoming future life. So it's necessary to be set a law or something, an age restriction, that after 12 the online platform or social media platform should be available for the teens and young adults.
As all knows, in past, we all criticize laptops, phones, and social media very much. But nowadays, in the corona time, all these things are very useful, as we know. With the help of only social platform, or children can survive, teacher can survive, children can study with the online platform only.
You are right. Because before you criticize a lot to all these stuffs. But now it's a condition, and also we don't have any choice also. So at this time, we are using all these stuffs for our need. It means we need, and we know that we have to take classes or do study anything. But if we see that at that time, what actually young teens and adults do, that they utilize their times on they are just watching YouTube videos, just scrolling on their platforms and everything. Playing games, watching movies. So that time and this time, I think totally different somehow. So now I think it's the best use of the laptops and so like this social media platforms or the.
So if you heard the news last year, the government banned some websites and PUBG game also. That is very very harmful for the children, as it spread very much among the children, hana. So government banned some websites also, some gaming zones also. So this is the right thing that government did or not?
Yeah, actually I think I totally agree with the government. Means they ban all these sites, because as they are just taking the private information of any people. So it's not any very good for us to share our personal details with any app, means if they ask for. And I think most of the apps are from China, so we don't have any enough idea means how they are utilizing our personal information. It can be anything, they can do anything. So I think, and also we can't do anything regarding this, so government have to take any steps.
We can't do
ban all this
anything regarding this, but nowadays some social websites are still very popular, like Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat. So they should be banned by the government or not?
I think this should not be banned, because
children, not for all over, but for the at least
for the children.
Yes, for the children.
Yeah, not be banned, but I think there must be some restriction also to utilize all the features. As I think any social media platform, like if you say chatting option, where people meet and greet, like makes the friends and other thing. So there must be some restriction, also an age restriction, because so many people make fake IDs and other thing, and they misguide or mislead.
Because we also use social platforms, so we can't say ban them, because of course we are also associated with these social websites. as well.
Right, right.
So, yeah. Yeah, with the help of Facebook, we can find our old friends also. As everyone knows.
Yeah, as well, yeah, friend also, and also do the, means like the marketing stuffs or to promote anything. So, this is a very good option if people do these type of activities. But to misguide the young youth or taking them to other side like the 18 plus sites and leaking the to posting the bad stuff or say like the 18 plus thing. Okay. So it's not a good for them to watch these types of things, because it will affect their mindset and surely it will misguide them towards their upcoming life.
Okay, sir, very good. You have a very good knowledge about on this topic. I really appreciate your knowledge. Okay, one question.
Thank you.
So, what are the negative effects of social media? Only the negative effects.
Actually, if I say like from the day, from the past, from the day human being evolved, so we know that these are never be a part of our life. And now today, we came to situation that we are nothing, nothing without the social media platform. So I think this is the biggest this.
As this is the first thing platforms. In the morning, whenever anyone wake up. First, they check their social websites, their WhatsApp, their Facebook, Instagram. And in the night, when they go to bed, the last thing is only the same. They check their social media platforms.
Yeah, we can say that means whenever we like early to rise, check your phones. And if you're early to bed, so just check your phone. And we also know. Yeah. And these things are never with us. These are means temporary. And not with us from the permanent, like from the day human evolved. So this is, I think, becoming very addictive to us, And I think like these things are developed or built so for our use. But now I think they are overtaking us.
Of course, they waste our free time. Basically, they waste our free time. Even people give their main time on the social media only, that they can use in other place, but they give their valuable time on the social media just for the checking the other people's posts and photos only. They're just wasting their time.
Actually, I think it's not the totally means I can't say that it's the mistake of the people also, because whenever we see that whenever this type of platform or apps are built, so the developer try to make them so much attractive or interactive towards the people that they can't, means we spend a lot of time in these sites.
Okay.
So,
according to my questions, we have to discuss like some negative effects of social media.
Okay. Right. Negative effects, right. So this is one of them, means it's become so much addictive that whenever we rise, we check our phones. And most of the time is every time within an hour, every hour we check our phones, like what happened next day, and we are not much focused on social life.
We can get involved in the criminal actions also sometimes, just because of the bad groups in the social media. Some people got involved in the criminal actions also as well. Even the kids also nowadays in the Facebook.
These type of stuff can be these type of actions means this type of stuff action is taken a part of lot of time also, and like people also people do a lot of fraud through these sites.
You
also
can say like this, by the fake peoples, by the fake IDs, people got involved in the crime actions. They say they think it's good. But after some time, they find, no, it's very, very bad. And they get involved. Already they get involved in this. So they are not able to get back easily. So that's why nowadays government has also a crime for this also. They have set up their office for the online crimes also. Even people get into depression also, as they think the other people are very happy, other people are very like enjoy their life, and we are nothing. We are just setting our home only by seeing other people's good photos, good videos, good posts. So they feel themselves ki they are very low. So that's of course a very negative effect, na? It's demotivized. If we see someone's other's good pictures, like they are enjoying, like they are doing holidays, they are going for the great vacations, and we are just sitting in our home only. So it is also gives us negative impact. So are you agree with this point?
Exactly. Yeah, I totally agree. Means nowadays we are so much interested in others' life. Means we are always try to compare with them. Like if we are having this, so what they have, and we always check the social media platform. We are not focusing on ourselves, and we are just looking what they have, what they are doing next, what their next move or what they are going to do in next, without and not focusing on ourselves. And this will totally, I think you are right. Means leads to the depression also, because social media makes everything so much faster that we don't have any patience on us.
And some people post fake news also. We can see for so many protests, people spread so many fake news with the help of the social platform only, and other people think they are the true news, and they get also involved in the protest on these things. But after some time, they find, oh, these are only fake. So that's very bad.
Yeah, also means with the use of the Photoshop. So totally they can misguide hundreds of peoples and they allow them, means also misguide them to participate for them. So with the creepy message.
Yeah, with the creepy message. It's not a creepy message, with the fake messages, you can say like this.
Yeah, fake.
With the fake message.
Fake or say, yeah. Right, fake message.
Fake message. So, at the end, we can conclude. Yeah, some scientists' inventions, of course, scientists' inventions are always useful for the human beings. It depends on the human beings only, how they use it. Of course, scientists invent these things, so this is very good for us. It's depend on only us, na, that if we use it in a bad way, because they give us the harmful effects only. But if we use only in a good way, like during corona time, these things are very useful, as people get in touch with each other only by these platforms. Even students get education only by these platforms. So these are the good things also. But when we spend our time, very valuable time on this, when we watch the vulgar videos on the YouTubes, on the Googles, these things of course are the bad, so negative impacts of course. So at the end we can say we have both the effects, advantages and disadvantages of everything. So same with the social media, we have some good advantages and some bad advantages also. Do you want to say anything else at the end?
I want to say like we know that social media is very necessary for all of us. And if we know how to manage, like if we manage our time and if we manage our time and know how to utilize these social media platforms, so surely it will be boon for us. Because like companies are already making a lot of money from these platforms.
Yes.
They are just, and it's hollowing the young youth and teens. So it's our responsibility to manage our times and utilize it. So if they are making money, so at least we can use it for our knowledge and so that we can get good from it. Instead of bad things.
Okay, Sachin. Very good. Very well spoken. And you are very, very aware by this topic, I must say.
Right. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am, for this compliment, ma'am.
No, of course. You deserve this. You are worth for this, na? Of course. Very good, Sachin.
Right.
It's very nice talking to you. Of course, you are aware for this. Okay. So, bye.
Thanks a lot, ma'am.